Hi friends, welcome to my channel Chetashree Amle. Last time we have learned that how to create a business page on Facebook. So hope you have seen my last video. In that video I have cleared you some basic things about a Facebook account and Facebook business page. So we have end up our last video, that in creation of the page we have set the logo of our page, we have set the cover photo of the page, and the remaining part was settings. So as I have told you that I'll cover that settings session in next video. So without wasting time friends, let's get started. So here is our page. So when we click on settings, so setting you will find here on the upper tab. So settings, if you want to check my previous video, you can visit a YouTube channel. I'll show you that where you can find my video also. So these are the settings basically. So first let's go with the general settings. So what else we are going to see in this whole video? So quickly get us some revision. In Facebook settings we are going to see the general settings. We are going to set our page information, which is very much important. If a user is visiting our page, of course he is going to look into the information about our page, that address, phone number, where we are located, what is our website, what is the phone number. And now the Facebook has updated the WhatsApp icon also, so that is the advantage. Then auto chatting session, that we are calling it a messaging, tabs and templates for your page, and how to set a notification for your page. So in this video we are going to see these five things. So here are the general settings. In general settings, there first one is the page visibility. So once you have created the page, you have to check here, is your page is published or it's unpublished. So your page should be published, okay, so people can see that page live on the Facebook account, okay. If you have some issues that you don't want your page to be live on the Facebooks, so at that time, instead of deleting it, you can just unpublish it. Okay, when you unpublish it, nobody can see your page at that time. So I don't want people to not show my page. I want people to show my page. So I'll keep it as publish, save, and okay. The second is visitors post. Anyone can publish on the page, anyone can add photos and videos to the page. So I'll keep this setting on when I have a restaurant, cafe, because I want people to post on my page. In this way my page will get more engagement, so I want more people to post on my page. But if when I have a corporate profile, I'll not like people to post on my business page, so at that time I'll keep the setting off. So let's see, allow visitors to the page to publish post, allow photos and videos post, review post by other people before they are published to the page, disable post by the other people on the page. I will disable this session because I don't want people to post on my page, okay, because it's it's not a public profile, it's a corporate business profile, so I don't want people to post on my page, so I'll just disable it. Save settings. Now the third is post and story sharing. Okay, post and story sharing is on. I'm allowing people, it's one and the same, people are sharing photos, stories, or that. I don't want people to share stories or any post, so I'll disable this session also. And saved. I want people to share their stories on my page. I want people to share my stories. I'll share my own stories on my page. Then next is audience optimization for the post. The ability to select news feed targeting and restrict the audience for the other post in turn off. Okay, so allow news feed targeting and ability to restrict the audience for your post. No, I don't want to select this, so I'll just leave it blank. Messages, people can contact my page privately. Yes, I want people to contact me because I want more business, because as people will contact me, they want to know about my business. In that way the communication is going on. So I want people to message me, I want them to ask me about the services, what kind of charges. So many clients ask these things on messages only. So yeah, it's work. I want people to message me. Then tagging ability, yes, I want people to tag me. Other tagging this pages, yes, I want people and other pages can tag my pages, yes. But obvious, I have other blogging pages also. So I'll keep this session on. In this way, I'll get more traffic to my page. Page locations for effects. Other people can use your page location for photo, videos, frame and effects. No, I don't want people to use my location for their post or anything. Country restrictions. Page is visible to everyone. Yes, if I want to restrict some country, I can just simply type here some country name. Suppose I don't want to show my page to China. Okay, so I'll just type China. I'll select it, China, and hide this page from viewers in this country. So people from this country will not be able to see my page. So I don't want to do this thing. It was just an example to show you. Now, age restrictions. You can put this age restrictions when your page has an adult content. But my page don't have any adult content. So I will not do any age restriction here. Then page moderation. No words are being blocked from this page. Okay. So if you want some words that should not be used in the comment section of your post, so you can simply create a list of that words. That words might be abuse words or something. So you can just simply create a list of that words and you can just upload that file here, so that words will be blocked from your page. So right now I have not done that thing. Then profanity filtered. Okay, now let's see what is profanity. The profanity filter, you can choose whether to block profanity from your page and to what degree. Facebook determines what to block by using the most commonly reported words and phrases marked offensive by the community. Okay, so I have kept that filter off. So they have given this filter in the terms of medium and strong. Means the abuse words are strong, so they will be blocked. If medium, they might be shown, or it's off only. So I don't know why Facebook has given this thing. Abuse are abused. Similar page suggestions. Yes, I need a similar page suggestions for my competitor analysis. So I have kept that session on. Yes, but obvious, page posts are automatically published when you update the page info. Reach milestone, receive reviews and more. Yes, I need updates for that things. So I'll keep that thing also on. Post in a multiple languages. Ability to write the post in multiple languages is turn off because I don't want it. I just want my post to be in English language. Translate automatically. Your post may show translation automatically for people who read in other languages. But obvious, many people uses Facebook in different languages as it's India and we are in Maharashtra. So people mostly use Marathi language and Hindi language. But obvious, people from Gujarat will serve the Facebook in Gujarati language. So multiple languages translations, you can keep this session on when you want translation of your post. So comment ranking, most relevant comments are shown of the page by default. Yes, keep this session on. Content distribution, So I have kept the download option on, download page option, then merge the pages. So when you have two different pages of the same businesses at that time, Facebook is giving you an opportunity to merge that audience of the two pages. But at that time, you should have a similar name of your pages to merge them. Facebook did not allow you to merge the pages with the different names. How I know this? Because one of my student have this error. So she was running two pages of the same business with the different names, and after some time she was having a good audience on both the pages. So at that time she want to merge that pages, but Facebook is not allowing her because Facebook considers it as you are misleading your audience. So Facebook is not allowing you to merge two pages with the different names. So at that time we have changed the name of pages, and after that we have tried to merge the pages, and yes, it works. Facebook has merged the two pages at that time. Delete your page. If you want to delete your page, you can delete it from here permanently, or if you want to unpublish it or don't want to show to the people for some time, you can just unpublish it from your page visibility. So these are the general settings we have covered. After that, the second is page information. If you have any questions regarding these settings, you can ask me in the comment below. And if you want to check my videos, previous videos, you can just go to the YouTube channel and you can type Chetashri Amle. And here are my videos, it's my channel. So you can see my videos, and this was the... Just a minute, this is my channel, so you can just visit to my channel. And yeah, this is the video, chapter 1, how to create a Facebook business page. So you can see my video, previous video here. Okay, so let's continue with this. So other interesting parts are remaining, how to set the auto message and auto chat box. So stay tuned with me and watch the complete video, guys. This is a page information session, so you need to describe your page. So here is the description of my page. Second is the categories. I have given two categories: the business services and internet marketing services, your phone number, your website, your email ID to contact. My email ID has been changed, so I'll just change my email ID here. contact@groinchhub.com. So just saved it. Okay, after that, location also has been changed. It's let me check my Groinchhub Private Limited. Is Facebook showing this location? Let me check. Yes, I don't think so. Okay, Malad West. Pin code is changes. Okay, then you can add the business hours also here. Products, I'm not selling any products, so I have not mentioned here any products. Privacy policy link you can share here. So these are your page information settings. The others are, I'll explain you the messaging settings at the end. So let's complete this templates and tab. What is templates actually means is there are different templates as per your businesses. If you having online shopping business, then Facebook has a different template for you. See, here I have gone in templates and tabs, and here is a template session open. So I have selected the business template. So you can just simply, if you're having an online shopping, so you can go with the online shopping or services template. Others are venues, if you're having an event, non-profit organization, politicians profile, restaurants or cafe, shopping, video page, and standard template. So these are the templates given by the Facebook. So you can select any of the template as per your business. And the other thing is tabs. Okay, so these tabs are so important. So I will show you where you can find these tabs. So this is my home page. After that, review, about us, post, videos, photos, events, offers, group, community, jobs available, subscribe dates, and services. So let's check it. So see where I'll see this. See, home, reviews, about us, post, videos, events. Okay, so now I'm going to this drag and drop this about us up, and I want people to check my, okay, this jobs after the reviews. Okay, so now it is auto saved. And if I want to add some different tabs, I can add some different tabs from here. So now let's see, refresh the page, let's see this about us is coming up or not. Yeah, see, this about us has changed as I have dragged this about us from year to year, and this job section has also come up as I have dragged that session from down to up. So these are the templates and tabs. The other is post attribution. So I'll just read out this thing for you. It's too simple, you can just read out the things. Facebook has given everything here. So since you manage the page micro inch up through digitized brand business manager, this is business manager account, I'll create a separate video on this business manager. So it's basically showing me the post attributions. So let's jump to the session of messaging. Most important, and I like this to explain. These are the message settings. So here you can set a feature and edit preference for managing the messages across the messenger and Instagram. You can manage notification settings in the notification tabs also. So from here you can manage and manage the conversation with your customers and clients who are coming to your business pages. So here is the first one in general settings. So use the return key to send the message. So press the return and enter key on a computer to send messenger or a Instagram messages. In this feature is off, click send. Okay, so basically you can set one key for a particular message as I'll show you one. So okay, so I'll type here, a key name is okay and its value is how can I help you. So when I type okay, so the automated message which will be sent to the customers will be how can I help you. So in this way this written key works. And second is starting a messenger conversation. So here is a greeting message. Greet people before they send you page a message. Your greeting appears in the chat window before the message if you send it. Okay, so this is a greeting message. I have already set for it, and I can change this greeting message as well. So actually I have set this message for my own company, so it's fine. So here is add personalization. So I have added the full name of a recipient. You can call him by the first name or last name or a Facebook page link or any website, phone number, email ID. But basically you have to call him by his name only. So you can use any three of this feature. Okay, so save. After that, here is your message URL. You can share this message URL on many social accounts and in WhatsApp, or suppose someone is asking you about your business page, Messenger. So you can share at that time this links. Add a messenger to your website. Now this is the new feature. You can also add a messenger to your website. So you just have to click on get started, and step by step installation will be explained by the Facebook to you. The third thing is, during the messenger conversation, set up automated responses. So here you can set automated responses in your inbox. Now after that, the next is, show who is sending message on behalf of your page. So I have kept this option on because this page is handled by my digital marketing executive. So yes, I want to show their names also. So at that time I'll keep this on. Or if I don't want to show on which behalf this message is going on, so at that time I'll keep this option off. My display name. Okay, so see here you can see the name Microinch Hub. So choose a name and a photo to display when you send a message on behalf of your page. If this setting is turned off, messages you send will be attributed on your page. Okay, so here is this option. It's also a new feature of Instagram. Okay, so on behalf of your full name, it will be shown to them. Okay, so these are the other display names to whom I have assigned the page role. So these are the message settings. The other one is templates and tabs. This is very interesting. So when you are creating a new page, so at that time the default template for your page will be set by the Facebook. So you can change that at by default. It might be a service template or a business template. So here are some interesting templates for your Facebook page. So the first one is business template, other is a service template. For service based companies or any services if you are providing, you can select this. For venue based, if you are an event designer, event planner, at that time you can use that. Non-profit organization, for a politician, restaurants or cafe, for a shopping, means for e-commerce you can select the shopping one. For video page, if you are a YouTuber, you can go with this video page template. And standard template, so if you are new to the Facebook page, Facebook will automatically set this template for you. So for my page, I have already set the template. So these are just some examples of templates in the Facebook page. Now the next is tabs. Now you will see what are these tabs are. So I'll show you one example. So see, these are tabs on my page. So where these tabs actually appears: about us, reviews, jobs, post, videos, photos, events, community, subscriber list, my services. So these are the tabs which will appear on the left side of my page. So home, about us, reviews. See, these are the tabs. Okay, so I can change the position of this tab. Suppose I want to show my reviews first, anyone who visit my page. So I'll show you that it changes. The review session will be now seen on the top. See, now the reviews are coming on the top. So in this way I can manage these tabs which have been shown on my page. So this, and I can also add tabs from here. If I want some new tabs or want to remove the tabs, I can remove that tab from here. Now let's get to notifications. So these are the notification. So get a notification each time there is an activity on your page or an important page updates. So whenever any activities are happening on your page, you can just track them with the help of notification. So these are the notifications which are already active. So here you can see if I want to turn off them. Suppose new page mention has been come, so I have turned on this notification, and if I turn off this options, so I will not get any notifications. Okay, and the others are message notification, email notification, text message notification, and group notification. So these are the other notification which you can track all the activities ongoing on your page. So if you like this video, if you have learned something from this video, please like this video and also share with your friends, family members, and also subscribe to my channel, so whenever I release a new video you will get the update. And thanks for watching this video, guys.